I think I like the hammer. It's quite close.
The hammer?
Yeah, because I like
Okay.
to. Then you can draft really aggressive, and then that hero power kind of snowballs it at the end. So,
Okay.
like a versatile mage hero power, but deals 2 damage as well.
Yeah. The 3-drop and the 5-drop are nice here.
They're both quite premium.
Yeah.
You just tell me which one you're leaning to.
Probably towards the Spectral Knight.
So in Shaman right now, and that's a very specific reason, fives aren't that great because of the 7/7. The 7/7 overloads you on five. Whereas
Yeah.
three drops become even better because after you
You
play that
played it before,
7/7, you
yeah.
play a three drop. So we can pick the spider tank here. Danny,
Okay.
just excuse me for 1 second. I'm gonna be right back. Oh, speaking
Sure.
of which, you can pick that one already. Yeah.
Easy. Dust Devil. I don't think we've picked the Dust Devil ever. Seven seven good. I think seven seven's pretty good. Pretty decent for 4 mana. Sing or Riot. Wait, you guys want me to sing? I can't sing. Please follow our traditions. What song am I singing? Seven seven Craig as in 12-0 confirmed. It's easy, like 12-0. Use your beautiful voice and sing something. Guys, the thing you should know is I cannot sing at all.
All right, I am back. Sorry for that, Danny.
Welcome
There we
back.
go. Whew.
Your cat is trying to get me to sing a song.
Oh yeah, they tend to do that, but they know better most of the
I
time. Whew. Is it as warm there as well? Because holy shit, it
am
is.
boiling right now.
All right, so we'll make it a face run, right? Like little
Yep.
like makes it a little bit more fun instead of the
It's
control.
my favorite type.
Oh yeah, good girl, good play. Axe here looks really good.
Yeah.
I think that's a pretty straightforward one. All right, this one's interesting. You can tell me what do you like here.
Either Frostwolf or Venge. I don't think Left Gnome is very good.
No, I mean after the nerf especially, it's
Yeah,
just
it's
not that
pretty
great.
bad. If we're going face, 7-6 looks pretty nice.
I think we're going with the Warlord because I think most of the time in Shaman, that thing's probably going to be about as big and just doesn't have the downside. So I like the Warlord a lot more. If we play Venchiko and it doesn't die, then we're really handicapped for our next turn, right? Then we're going to
Yeah.
have to play something worse.
I guess ship's cannon here.
Yep, that's a good 2-drop. It's good enough.
Hex is nice removal.
Oh yeah, Hex is really good.
So we taking the hex?
Yeah, for sure. It's, the fact it's 3 mana is crazy. Oh, wow.
Are we going face this again here?
What do you think?
Seems good.
I think I'd pick the Fire Rally. It's
Fire
more
Rally.
versatile.
Yeah,
Yeah, the thing is like the well, I mean it goes face, right? It's
it
three phase. But the face is does have its downsides. If you play it and it does get sapped, it does get hexed or something, you're in a really bad spot.
Yeah,
Whereas
that's
Fire
true.
Rally is almost like you can never really be too sad about having a fire elemental in your hand.
Seems good.
All
The Berserker.
Yep, Mani Berserker. Solid. The other two are a little wonky.
I'm not even sure what you would pick here, the heal bot or the Corsair.
Yeah, it's not a good pack, that's for sure. I think, even though it goes against our smirk principles, I think we'd probably pick up the heal bot.
Okay.
Seeing as, you know, we could hit an evolve and then evolve it away or something.
Yeah. Probably Yeti here.
Yep, Kaneko Yeti, looking good.
I don't know, would you go for a lightning storm?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. I
For
think
lightning storm?
AoE is
Okay.
pretty rare, and especially against shamans, people don't play around it for
Yeah.
good reason because it's rare. But then you know we're gonna be the lucky ones that actually have it. So let's go with that.
Maybe ship's cannon or flame. I don't
Okay. So do you play any shaman in constructed?
Yeah, just flame tongue. That's
Yeah, I think you know in
okay.
constructed it's the same deal that the flame tongue is just really good, right? So it's even better in arena really because people can't deal with it as well as they can in constructed, and then it's
Okay.
just sitting there, it keeps buffing your guys. It's really nice.
The fairy dragon is quite nice. Spectral knight also.
I think for the same reason as we mentioned earlier, we go with the fairy dragon here. We also
Okay.
have axe, which increases the need for two drops. Because we're going to be overloaded on three, so.
Yep. The horse rider here.
Yep, horse rider with a flame tongue. It's pretty nice.
Hex again.
Yeah, you're pretty good at drafting Shaman, Denny. Look at this. This is
Seems
shape
good.
and. Oh, dear Lord. Okay. It's going to be quite fun. All right, guys. You guys feeling this run? I'm feeling this run. Look at
It
this.
looks like a pretty good run.
Yeah. So, 7-7. Looks
Close.
good. Very nice.
Again.
Okay, so maybe not, but we'll see. Just
Huskar
comes
here.
up. All right, let's think about this for a sec. So, 7-7s are obviously great, right?
Yeah.
Okay, chat, we need you here. We need your help.
Chat. Okay.
So, type flame wreath or faces or whatever or totemic for your vote. I need you to assist me here.
We've actually had four faceless in the draft so far.
Yeah, that's true. We've seen four faces. That's crazy.
I need more 7/7. Can never have enough 7/7s.
7-7 boys. Tuskar suck? I mean, Tuskar doesn't suck. Nowhere near. Stormfight Commander.
That's not even in the count. Like, I didn't even see that anywhere on the
Yeah,
board.
it's two blue cards, and we're thinking about those. Hey guys, don't spam, right? That's cheating. You guys are influencing the poll. All right. I think just for the memes, we go for the 7-7. Just, you know, let's have some fun with it.
Yep.
Oh dear God. Okay, that's nice.
Would you go for the removal here?
Yeah,
Okay,
Stormcrack.
Stonecrack.
Even though it doesn't go face, it's still
Is
good.
two corrupted healbots
I
too
think
much?
because we have three faces, I mean, we have 2 5-drops, and I think that's it. I don't think we want more 5-drops. So I'd pick the Evolve here.
The
It's
evolve, okay.
not an amazing card. When it came out, people were like, yeah, Evolve, it's so good, it's so good. And then it kind of, the hype died down, and was like, well, maybe it's not that great. Because you are still dumping a card into it. And especially with the 7-7s, it's not so good because you know you're evolving a 7-7
Yeah,
into
it's
a
probably gonna be
5-drop.
worse.
So yeah. This one's really interesting, this pick. Quite curious what you want.
Not even sure what I would go for. Maybe the Yeti, but then we have faceless for 4 mana.
I think the right pick here is Earthen. I think we
Yeah,
play the
the first
seven-seven
game.
on four, and then kill something and then heal it back up. I think it's
Heal
gonna
it
be
back
really strong.
the 3-drop.
I think so. I'm just thinking if the taunt would make any sense. I don't think so. I think the regent makes more
Okay.
sense. Yeah. Because using your hero power with Shaman and the regent's pretty cool.
So tiny fin here for sure.
Easy, easy tiny fin. So
Yes.
we can evolve him into a Goldshire footprint.
Is Earthshock any good in arena?
Yeah, I think, I mean, it's just because we don't have a ping, having a ping is all right. And then sometimes, you know, it hits a Crusader or it hits a or a taunt, right, for lethal. So I think the versatility makes it good.
Okay.
If it was just if it was just one mana, one damage, it wouldn't be good. But because, you know, sometimes it's more than that, then it's pretty good.
Maybe the one drop for the seven drop.
I don't think it's Primal Fusion, seeing as the only extra totem we have is Flame Tongue. So then it's either the big drop or the Dragonling. The Dragonling does have some of merit with Evolve, because, you know, you put two things on the board and they evolve. Right. I think overall I'd still pick the Captured Euromonger.
Okay.
Yep.
Probably Horse Rider?
Yeah, more Horse Rider. This is looking pretty cool.
Kraken or Arena
Guy?
Oh
yeah, Kraken. Kraken. Sure. All day, every day, Kraken.
Faceless?
All right, so here's where we think about things, right? And whether it's going to screw our curve at any point. Because Krakal is pretty good as well. All right, chats, don't spam, but what do you want here? Do you want another 7-7?
Another 7-7.
I think that chat will probably try to sell us on this one. They definitely, like, screw each other over as well, because you have two of them in your hand. You know, you play one on four, you can't play another one.
It's fine, we just save coin, you know?
7-7. So Crackle does go face as well. This is really a tough call. I mean, Mukla's even is pretty good in Shaman, but I think we're a pretty aggressive one.
Yeah. Crackle is smart face, this is fun.
Well, that depends what kind of a draft you're doing there, right? maybe if I would have said this one's not on the record. We do have a lot of threes for our turn four.
We do.
One, two, three, four, five threes. All right, we'll pick the 7-7 just for memes. That's fine.
The 7-7.
Yeah, I think the Crackle's the better pick, but they can get away with it.
Probably the Giblin.
Let's see how many twos we have first, because Kraken is really good. Sure. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is all about how greedy we want to be. I think I pick another Kraken here.
A Kraken?
Yeah.
Probably the Vendor. Or the spawn.
It's definitely between those two. I don't think it's the five ever. You know, we've got four faces. So spawn is pretty decent in Shaman. But this deck has become so high value that the Vendor might actually not be bad. Yeah, I think I like the Vendor more. I think staying alive is just a priority for this deck. I don't think that we're too afraid of the late game. Oh my god, this deck.
I haven't seen Belcher in such a long time.
Well, he's still alive and kicking in the arena.
Yeah. Thunderbluff is quite good though in Shaman.
Yeah, so if this is pick one, we would have already picked the Valiant and moved on.
Yeah,
but it's not. It's pick 30.
30. It's our last one.
And we've got two Krakens, you know, fire elemental, 4/7/7. So this is where you start thinking: do I just want the taunt to stay alive because my deck is insane? And I think that is the reasoning we'll go with here. We don't need more value. We've got enough value. We've got 4/7/7. Yeah, I think we just want to stay alive. Yeah, I think the right pick would have been definitely the Kraken, but I mean, let's go for the memes. All right, let me just check if we got the deck list, and then we're good to go.
Okay.
No legendary. Yeah, never lucky
But
guys.
why do we need legendary when we have four mana seven sevens?
Budget. Budget legendary deck. All right, let me just. So we're here. All right, Danny, you can stop sharing your screen and then you can add me. So you just, there should be like just the green button, stop sharing. And I should go back to the webcam. There we go. Excellent. And then you can add me in game. That's Shady Bunny 2343.
Wait, can you send that to me on
Shady
Slack?
Bunny 2344. Oh, just type it up. All right, let me, I'm not quite sure if there's a space in between here, but this is the that's the numbers. Could be that there's a space between this and all right, got
All
it.
right, send a request.
All right, we're good to go, Denny. We queue it up and yeah, we can take our meme deck for a walk. That's quite interesting. The chat can see my rank 12. Look at that, guys. Quite proud of that. Yeah, 4 times 7 is 28, plus the hammer is lethal. Yeah,
Yeah, we have
that's
lethal
good
AZ.
math. So, I mean, compared to some constructed decks, I think that, in constructed, you'd probably want more 7/7s if you could get them, right?
Of course, just have a deck full
A
of
deck
seven
full of, well,
seven.
I mean, then you're not playing anything on a lot of turns. Memes? Oh yeah, memes are coming, guys.
So we just keep the two drop and three drop here.
So the 2-drop for sure. I don't think you keep the 3-drop. I think it's just the
Okay.
2. I think we want that 3-drop on turn 5 anyways. So
Right.
just looking for our axe, we're looking for a horse rider or something like that. Maybe a 7/7, right?
Maybe both.
Or yeah, can I tell you this every time and you can get me those cards? Because that would be really nice. Thanks.
So we just end for now.
Maybe
But would
not,
you
I
coin
think
it
about
out?
it. So if we coin out the Amani, then the tricky thing is then we can't horse rider on 3 if we axe on 2. So I'm actually okay with passing here. It's fine.
Okay.
Oh wow, that's great. So now there's even a world where we axe instead of Amani. So my thinking here is that next turn we could coin horse rider.
If we X now.
Yeah. On the other hand, if we have money, we could still just. Yeah, I like the axe. Because,
The X, okay.
yeah, because he's a mage, right? So he's
Yeah.
more prone to just remove stuff. Yep, that's fine. I can call all the cards. Yeah. Man. I called the opponent's implosion for 4 when he had a councilman on the board.
Wow.
That was interesting. Yeah. So he didn't play a standard 4-drop. Sorry, standard 3-drop. So this one's interesting. What do you prefer here?
Maybe even coining out Horse Rider. Do we have 4 minutes? Yeah, maybe coin up because then he'll on turn four he'd have to ping to
Well, he
get
doesn't
rid of
have
it.
to, right? He could play a 4-drop.
No,
He could
yeah,
play a
he
4-drop
could
if he
play
wants to.
something.
I think the Amani and Killer's Shield is fine, because the next turn you can
Just the
coin a
money killing
5 into
shield.
a 5.
Okay.
Yep. It's weird, but we're gonna ramp past turn 4 with this deck. I think that's one of the only that's one of the only times we have this. Do I predict a 12? No, it's Shaman. So even if you have a 6 Shaman deck, I don't think you can predict a 12. It's I mean the last 6 Shaman I had went 12, but a lot of things can happen. And
That's true.
I'm not sure how good 4 7/7s are. So it's a
It
good test drive here. I don't think I've had four
is a
seven
good
sevens.
test.
Every time Shady says interesting, you pour a shot. Oh man, I'm gonna go overdrive then round soon. It's interesting proposition out there.
So I would just coin Corrupted Healbot Shades into the 3/6 and X the 2/1.
We actually have an, I was gonna say interesting play, but we
Oh.
have quite a fun play here with the
Okay.
Flametongue and the Horse Rider. So you could technically put the Flametongue down, coin out the Horse Rider. Horse Rider hits the Water Ally for 4, face
Yeah.
kills off the Water Ally, Amani kills a 2-1, and you've got a 5-1, you've got a 7-1, and a 4-1. If he has Twilight Flame Caller, you can not use your face to kill it, but you can Belcher to block it out from your totem. So
okay.
It actually looks better, I think, to do this. Positioning is going to be a little tricky, so I think we want the Horse Rider on the right. Actually, no, on the left, because he's going to kill the Amani for sure. I want the left to be... So we put the Flame Tongue on the far left.
Yep.
Coin Horse Rider. Face and Horse Rider into the Water Alley. 4-3 into the 2-1. Yeah. So then he's going to kill off the Amani, and then the right-hand side is free for totems.
Yep.
That's good.
4 7-7s and still not drawn. That is true.
Never lucky, guys. Well, we'll get them in the late game when the overload is better. That'll be quite good. Sure. I can deal with that, I think. What do you like here?
Just Corrupted Heal, but it's quite good. Or you could Silver Hand Hero Power.
I think Silver Hand Hero Power, that sets up for a really nice Frost Wolf as well.
Yeah, for the next turn.
Yep, I like that. Just getting some free value. Right, usually I'd put her on the far left, because positioning-wise, you're going to want to... I mean, we've already used our Flame Tongue, but it's always good to pretend like you still have one. So I like to put the strongest minions on the left in most cases. But then against Cone of Cold, it can be a little bit different, so... We'll go over that. Sure.
And you could hex it. Play Ship's Cannon.
It's not bad. Thinking if there's a world where we Warlord here. If we Warlord face, he can't. If he AoEs us, and he has to trade into the Warlord, that's kind of okay, I think. Well, okay, so my concern is that if we hex Hero Power, he's just going to Flamestrike.
Flamestrike, that's quite big. And then if we Warlord, then at least his minion will die as well.
Yeah, I think I would Warlord on the far left and just go face with our minions. I think he's less likely to Flamestrike now, and if he Flamestrike, he might go 6 phase. If he Flamestrikes and trades, I'm not too upset. But we still have Hex, and we can go Corrupted Heal Bot 2-drop or something. Cool.
Summoning Stone.
Memes. Alright. Just let me know what you're thinking about, Denny.
I think you could Fire Ellie, the 2-3, kill off the Summoning Stone, ignore the 6-7 for now.
I think we're always hexing this turn. I think it's just too good of a removal. So you could start with that, hexing the 6-7.
Okay.
What do you like from here? Hero Power seems a good start.
Yeah, Hero Power is fine. Are we dropping the 2-drop?
Well, we'll start to see with what totem we get. So I think the 1-1 always kills the Hex. Start with that. I think we have to kill the totem. Sorry, the Summoning Stone, because otherwise that's...
So we use weapon, everything.
We use everything. And then I'd probably just chill, because if he has a Flame Strike here, he's already getting enough.
A value, yeah, that's true.
But I don't want to give him a free 7 drop for his Flame Strike. That seems a little bit too much. Donut,
do you think
the
if he
host
had a
troll
flame
is now
strike?
Hosting. Sorry, Danny, what were we saying?
No, do you think if he had a Flame Strike, he would have used it last turn?
Maybe he was going to get real greedy, because you don't know, right? You never know how greedy people are. Because I can see him thinking like, well, you know, if I use this summoning stone, I might get a 7-rope. So I think, you know, this shows that he doesn't have it. Yeah, you see what I see, right? 5 and 3 to kill that.
Yeah.
Cool. Positioning-wise, we'll do it a little bit different. We'll put the fire only on the far right now, because we don't have a flame tongue anymore, and we want to play around Cone of Cold.
Okay.
Yep.
Another we one kill one. The 2-1 with
1-1. Yep. And then we go face with the rest. That is so disgusting. Oh.
It's great.
It's like, hey, that's a Bok Creeper. All right, you're dead. So.
Easy removal.
He goes for the miracle. Does he find it?
He's using it. Nourish. So no.
Oh, JB. Alright, cool. Not a single 7-7, by the way.
I know.
But we drew all the other good stuff. We drew a hex, we drew our fire alley, it was all good. This isn't disgusting enough. Where are our 7-7s? Yeah.
We need more 7-7s.
We're not winning hard enough, damn it. We only killed his Bok for, like, what, 2 mana?
Let's go again.
Yeah, you can just permac you unless I specifically ask you not to, Denny.
Okay. He didn't get the 1 mana existing there. Such a shame.
This guy. I guess, you know, he could have gotten a Nova, something like that. Maybe Ice Block. Those are like the only things that would have done something.
It would send back everything.
Yeah, it would do the same. We are playing against the anti 7-7 class, so this is kind of risky because it can just sap it. Oh wow, this axe is coming out all the time. It's nice. This deck is hexes, 7-7s, and krakens. Two krakens. Kind of, yeah. Because in arena, like kraken is considered like the best neutral. It's just
okay.
Yeah, it's the games go long enough that he comes down, and when he comes down, he usually decides the game. So it's very difficult to stop a kraken from winning the game.
Yeah.
Only light bomb. Oh yeah, light bomb. I guess nothing lives, right? Fire Ollie's dead, our big boy's dead. Yeah. Speaking of which.
I don't think we play anything this turn. Oh.
No, I don't think so either. It's fine. We'll just react to what he does. Mm-hmm. Our coin's gonna come in handy with these overload cards.
So. Yeah. Denny, what do you normally play in Constructed? Just anything that's working at the moment. For example, if C'thun Warrior is what's working, then I'll play C'thun Warrior. If I'm facing loads of warriors, I'll switch to Hunter. If I'm facing Zoo, just something that goes against it.
Good class. Good Hunter. What do you think?
So is it bad to ship's cannon and then coin out faceless next turn?
Kind of, because that puts us in like a really like, if he has sap, he wins the game moment. Mm. So I think here I would just drop the axe. And,
the axe, okay.
Yeah, just not give him anything to interact with. Because Rogues, you know, he daggered up as well, so he's just looking to kill something with, say, a poison or whatever. Mm-hmm. And by playing the axe here, you can just play your cannon on 3 and then faces on curve, or you could still, you know, coin something else. Yeah, that's pretty good. Just to play that into our weapon.
Yep.
Seems good. Kill this guy, play the cannon. Straightforward play this turn. And then he might have 1 damage, right? From a Valiant or whatever.
But, yeah.
You know, at some point we need to give him something. So. Just all bait. All bait for the sevens. Come on. Just
use all removal now.
Against shamans, I tend to keep sap for this exact reason. So let's hope he doesn't do the same thing. Okay, just trying to figure out if there's any world where we don't drop a 7-7. I don't think so.
Probably not.
No. All right, 7-7, go. We'll put him on the left.
And yep.
Two phase. I don't think we hit the golem. Maybe. So the reasons why I don't want to hit is because he might Shadow Strike and trade it into the 7.
Yeah.
So I think passing is fine.
Okay.
Alright, so please, no zap one time. So we could coin a 7-7 here. Nice. 7-7, coin 7-7. Yep.
Yeah, that's pretty great.
Ha! That's not an answer. Alright.
So we X the 3-4 shield, trade in 7-7. Coin out 7-7?
Yeah, just thinking if there's any world where we Lightning Storm. I don't think so, right? There's no way we get through. No. So yeah, face into his guy, 7-7 into his guy, for sure.
Yep.
Yeah, if we coin 7-7 now, we have 4 mana next turn.
Mm-hmm.
We can play Lightning Storm or the horse guy. That's okay, yeah. Another 7-7. So Betrayal is like the best card ever right now. It's 2 mana, 7 damage, and then he kills the other one. So please don't. Please don't.
He doesn't have it, it's fine.
Oh, he's a little bit too happy. All right, that's fine.
Shadow Strike. Cool.
He had that. Chose not to use it. Went for the Annoyatron, Psychotron instead.
Watch him Betrayal. He went Betrayal.
Nah, he didn't do it, guys. He didn't do it. I've lost my touch. I'm not calling the beats anymore.
It's because we have this awesome Shaman deck.
We're immune. Okay. He dealt with it. How dare he? Okay. Only rogues can do this. Right? Other classes are pretty much lost at this point.
Lightning Storm doesn't seem so bad.
So let's see. That overloads us, so that makes it. So the next turn we have 5 mana.
Yeah.
If we high roll, the board gets cleared without taking 6. If we don't, we take 6. If we Horse Rider, we kill his guy and we don't overload. But the next turn we have 7 mana. Don't really get anything particularly good for 7 mana. I'm okay with the Storm. Yep.
Storm?
Yep.
That's great. Clears right. Everything.
Yeah, you just high roll the pirate for me and then we're good.
Good one.
Good job. All right, look at that. Lovely.
Pretty pro at this, you know.
Yeah, I was about to say it's pretty enjoyable playing arenas with you, Danny. 4-7-7s, high rolling stuff. It's all good. I'm just kind of making fun of that because we were talking about it earlier, how, you know, some people perceive themselves as less lucky than other people. Oh, Lena, thanks so much for the 17 months in a row. Let's throw some love in the chat for Lena, please. Thanks so much. Now, we were talking about it. There's a lot of people who go like, oh, you know, I have bad RNG, so, you know, I usually don't play this game or blah, blah, blah.
That's terrible RNG unconstructed.
No, don't say that, Denny. I was making fun of those people. Right? It's I don't know. I feel like it's more of a sample size thing as well. If you you can be unlucky over a certain span of games, but I think
you'll get lucky afterwards.
Yeah, but we usually forget those times, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where you RNG because what do you want to do here?
5 mana. I mean, we can drop Corrupted Heal, but we can also Argent Amani, Spider Tank Amani.
Next turn, 8 mana.
Yeah. I mean, if we heal bot, how will he deal with it? Because he used so much removal, he didn't have steps.
Just anything that he has. I'm just thinking if we're in a better spot, if we Horse Rider and the Amani this turn.
Mm-hmm.
Next turn, 8. We don't really do much for 8. Well, we play Corrupted and Spider Tank. If we play Corrupted now, next turn we're probably going to have to play Horse Rider. So that means 5 mana left, that's not that great. Yeah, I like the Horse Rider and the Amani here.
Yeah,
I like to just deal with this guy.
Okay. So we kill his 3-4.
Yeah, we kill his guy. We were talking about you, LP fan, because you're like the poster boy for that shit, right? Where he's like, I have bad RNG. But you say it so much, you're going to believe it as well, right?
That's true.
Role-playing Crip. Oh, right, he ganked that up. I almost forgot about that. Sure. These draws are getting pretty good.
So we flame tongue to trade into 2/4.
So that means we have 6 mana left. So that means we're either playing Corrupted Healbot or Spider Tank Hero Power. Do you think you could roll a Town Totem for me? You
Would
wanna
you like to
try?
try it?
Yeah, because Healing Totem's quite good as well. So I think the totem's worth it. All right, he's done. He's like,
He's like, I'm done with this
yeah.
shit.
I mean, we have so many cards. We're on 20 life. He's not breaking through this. So yeah. Looks good.
Awesome.
All right, guys, 2-0 with the Shaman. Oh, look at that nice thrall pick there, guys. Look at that overlay. Beautiful. You guys too slow. Yeah, the rogue was out of there. Gotta go fast. I can kind of get it though. I mean, we're at that point. We're just kind of playing with our food, right? We're
Yeah.
just going. How are we gonna kill this guy? You know, like this, going like
The
that.
best way to kill him.
Just trying to figure like how could he possibly win this? How do we beat a Deathwing from this point?
So we keep back, send back the other two.
Yep, looks good. Keeping an axe. This axe has been in our opening hand every game. It's amazing.
Let's just draw it every game.
It's been working out really well. All
So we'll just
right.
pass here.
Yep, I'll just pass here.
Well, we have a nice two into spider tank.
Well, the thing is, the axe overloads, right? So if
Ah,
we,
that's true, that's true.
but he kind of played the perfect axe target, you know.
Juggler? Really?
Oh, that's a really nice draw because now we can axe into Fairy Dragon.
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Let's do that. If someone plays too slow, you might concede, but never in arena. So for you, arena is more important, Snorrazord. Or I guess it's because if it comes from a constructive player, they might say, I'll just concede in arena, but never in constructive, right?
So we drop Fairy Dragon and kill that as well.
Yeah, Fairy Dragon, kill this guy. It was like a very slight consideration to Flame Tongue preemptively, so you can Horse Kai for 4. That, you know, you could just play a weapon and kill it, so that's no
Yeah.
good. Like that. All right, so he's gonna miss, right? Yeah, there we go. It's like we have an
Oh
aura, we're protected. We just have good RNG. It's like nothing can touch us.
Should you go Argent here? Or Flame Tongue Hero
I
Power?
think Flame Tongue Hero Power is quite alright because he doesn't have accuracy on nothing. So, like the Hero Power, and I'm Flame Tongue in the middle, and I'm bam. That RNG, yeah, guys. We have a good RNG shield for this run.
Yes,
Oh my
nice.
god, and the taunt as well! Oh wow, that's crazy good, guys. That poor Bone Guard was thrown out to die. He was. Oh, does he miss into the totem? Oh, nope. He takes the 5. Not the worst guy for him, I suppose.
I mean, do we Argent and kill the 2/6? So with axe and Argent.
The question is whether we use our face or the totem now that we can use the totem.
Well, why wouldn't we use our face?
Because we can't use the face anymore next. So we're probably using our face. I'm just thinking. So I'm thinking if he has something to deal with the Flame Tongue next turn, then this totem can't attack anymore, whereas our face could still attack. So it's kind of a safer investment. I think I like that. I think I like the Argent on the left, and then just double trade your minions and hero power again, and then just roll another taunt. I guess.
Okay.
Okay. It's just a precaution to get value out of this Flame Tongue, like guaranteed.
Yep. It's not the top this time.
So, Ghoul is pretty atrocious here.
Yeah.
Oh, that's one of the cards in his early game. Oh, wow. Beautiful.
Okay. I mean, I don't know if you would drop a belcher here.
I think we're doubting between playing double 3-drop or playing a vendor and doing another hero power. What are you thinking?
But I mean, are we playing a lot into Brawl if we double 3-drop?
Brawl is generally not a card in arena. It's not
Oh,
really.
really?
But I think the vendor is just better, just get some more value out of our hero power.
Okay, so we
So
vendor.
vendor on the far left. Trade off the horse guy. Hero power. Now face for three. It's more like we have an infinite value engine now with this flamethrower and totem, so just hero powering every turn looks good.
So warriors don't generally draw brawls on arena rounds?
If they see them, yeah, but they're epics, right? So yeah. It's not very likely to get a brawl. Finally, we get some 7-7 in here. Is it the right play, though? Maybe it is.
Well, 4-drop, 3-drop doesn't seem bad.
Yeah, we could even use the 5 to kill his guy and then heal it back up.
Yeah. We do 5 and weapon.
So I think the things that happened for sure is 5 goes into his guy, faces okay. Goes on the far left. And then I think the earthen ring goes between the flame tongue and the 5-1, healing up the 5-1. Mm-hmm. And then I'd probably, you know, same school of thought, use the totem to kill his guy to get value out of the totem and
yeah.
Then throw the taunt phase. Yep. And then this is kind of a weird construction because there's a lot of things on the left-hand side, but that's just to make sure that the totems can keep getting value.
Yeah. Of course, you always put the big ones on the left.
Yeah, and the thing is, like, I'll explain and over-explain things all the time, but that's mainly yeah. Also for the stream, so don't feel patronized. It's fine. It's kind of the trademark. My stream merch, more educational. I leave the memeing to the other streamers.
Seems good.
That was pretty good deck, guys. The Shaman deck, pretty good. as long as we keep drawing this axe in the opening hand, I think we're pretty good. All right, mage. Interesting. That is usually a test. All right.
We don't keep revolve. I don't think we keep charged hammer. Question: do you keep the 3-drop?
I think the fairy dragon and the horse guy can stay. Yeah.
Okay.
12 win RNG. Yeah, Alodin. All right. So this is the first hand. I would say that's not like crazy.
The other
hands have been pretty insane. Leave the memeing to us. Feels good, man. Yeah, you guys got the memes. You guys bring the memes. Shady is the man of positioning. Yeah, the boring, slow, put things in the right spots play.
So you just end turn.
Yeah, I would end turn, and especially against mage. Mage pretty known for removal. You can flame cannon that. Crackle is better, but we'll pick 7-7 for the memes. I like to leave the memeing to the other streamers. Well, polls. We do a guest right now, right? So it's more peer pressure by you guys. It hasn't really been an issue that we've had 7-7 instead of a crackle yet.
So we dropped Fairy Dragon now.
I think so. Yep, I think it's fine. Can't ping it. He could play Flame Caller and then trade off one guy. Mm-hmm. But then we could horse guy the Flame Caller, which isn't too bad. Might even be a world where we coin a charged hammer to kill this guy just to get that rolling. Someday I'll be just like you. Flame Cannon for one? No.
Fair images.
And the trades.
Wow, he's trading.
Okay. He wants to protect those taunts.
I mean, you can coin 4-drop and then you can play Argent the next turn, or you can just Argent now. But
I kind of like the hammer here, just coin the hammer just to get
coin
to work.
Hammer.
Yeah, like we coin the hammer to get to work on those taunts, and then we can drop a 7-7 next turn, and then it's not going to get blocked by taunts.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. You could even do it differently where you just hammer in the next turn, use the horse guy.
Mm-hmm.
To get rid of the 3-2, let's say if we get a good Urk Shock here, but it's probably a 7-7. Although he does get a Polymorph for 3, Fireball for 3, so it becomes a lot easier to kill it for him. It's also, this weapon's really good if you get it rolling early. No!
What are Ellie's? Oh, well, you can Earth Shock it.
We could. It's not exactly what we want to do, though.
Nope.
I think it's just the feels bad, man. 7-7, kill the 0-2, and then if he has something, we probably lose.
But we go for it anyway.
Yep. Because the other play just doesn't win. Or chucking a water alley preemptively just doesn't do enough. So he's most likely going to freeze our face here, and then we're most likely going to have to kill that with our 7-7.
So, if he doesn't fireball.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wait. Yes, yes, more of that. Yeah. Very good. Wait, what? He's beating himself. I love this.
Why would you do that?
I have no idea, and I'm not going to ask.
Well, we just...
Argent tank heal is 5-4? That looks
yeah, good. Yeah, I would say Argent weapon is 5-4.
Yeah, we just protect our 7-4 here. Yeah, yeah. I don't know, he's suffering from mage syndrome where he probably just won the other games just herpeter from him. Now he's 3-0 and he doesn't know how he got there either. Yeah, that's crazy. Saving you one health? Yeah. But in what world do you trade your water rally into that thing first, guys? That makes no sense, right?
Totally.
You could silence your own 7-7. Yeah, but what's the point? You'd rather kill the 5, right? Isn't that better, guys, killing a 5? For me, it's better. Huh, so this is the turn where we get access to our new hero power if we use our weapon here. So we could use our face into the girl, Stormcrack plus hero power into the Toshli, Earthshock the Toshli, 7 face. He doesn't get a second spare part. We're overloaded for 1. Next turn we have 6 mana again. It's not the best, but I think it's good enough, right? It gets our hero power rolling as well.
Yeah, so we kill 2-1.
Yeah, face into the 2-1, Stormcrack hero power into the Toshli, or Chuck Toshli. And then 7 face and see if we can deal with it. Charged Hammer pretty good in this particular game, because we got it rolling so early. And I did something useful. Hero power first? Well, you wouldn't have enough mana, right? Unless you roll spell power specifically.
Yeah, but spell power.
Yeah. I don't think I'm gonna gamble on that one. Just for a free totem. And the Urchuk wasn't useless because it did deny him a spare part, so it's less chance for a freeze.
You could trade the 2-4, drop 7-7, kill 2-1. Or, you know, Belcher, kill 2-4. I
wonder. You killing the 2-4 would be playing around Flamestrike. I think that's fair. I think 7-4 into 2-4, ping his mech and drop another 7-7 is fine.
Okay.
Yep. I think most of the time I'd push that 7 face, but we're actually outcarding him. So there's no point in giving him a good flame strike. I think it's fine.
Alright.
Obviously he gets his trait that he wants here, the 2-1 into the 7-2, but got so much value, I think it's fine. We are just
trading.
Huh, so we can't ping. It's fine.
Again, he's still gonna have to trade it.
Yeah, he still has to trade the 3-2, and we might not have to trade the 6. Depends on how much we want to connect for 7.
Six mana arena.
Hmm. What are you thinking here, Denny?
If we crop the kill bot, just go face with 7-7. And that's two minions he has to deal with. He hasn't had the removal to deal with them.
I think we do have to kill that 6-6 just because the egg gets value as well. So I think we kill. Yeah, let's start.
We trade in.
Yeah, we trade in the 6-6 with the 7. Yep. I'm just not sure what I want to do here.
Who's going to ping it? For sure.
Yeah. It's probably better to just drop the heal bot.
Okay.
With the 6-6 out. Yeah. Pretty clear he thought he had 9 mana. Yeah, I think so too, Pauls. There was like this pause. He thought he was going to use the egg and the ping into our guy. And he took the 4-3. Then he was like, ah, shucks.
Wow.
Just slowly outvaluing. Yeah, what's going on in the background, by the way, Denny? We get some noise from time to time.
My family's downstairs.
Oh, okay, sure. Sorry.
Yeah, sorry.
No, just curious. Just curious. Well, then, I think that settles that. You want to crack in the 3-3?
Yep.
All right. 6 face. So that sets up lethal as well. That's 17, so no removal, no taunt. We have many. So guys, we're all good. Nobody's dying. It's just some background noise.
Yeah.
The Kraken status is released. Alright. GG, 4-0. Very nice.
What is he doing?
I think he's just trying to make it as likely for us to trade this in. He's like, look, it's gonna die to the chow, you gotta kill something now, but
we just go face.
Yeah, we go face and ping his face. And he's dead.
That was good, man.
Yeah, this game was pretty meme-y, right? He did some. We would have been in trouble if he froze our face with that water rally, because then we don't get our hero power. The turn we did, and so but yeah, it worked out really nicely. Yeah, the value on this deck is pretty crazy. I have to keep reminding myself that I don't have totem anymore, because that's the first thing that came up to me like twice. Like, oh, what if I roll a healing totem? It's like, oh no, wait, we can't do that anymore.
Nope.
Too damaged. Right now. Alright guys, remember guys, if you're having a good time, make sure to hit the follow button. It's always very much appreciated. Follow me on Twitter as well if you haven't already. I announce there when I'm streaming, and you know, when there's something nice going on like this co-op with Denny, I'll put that out there as well. Alright, Denny.
But you keep a 3-drop here.
Yeah, tank is premium. Keep a fairy and a tank, looking really good. Sell out? Nah, not really, guys. It's just logical, right? It's more for you guys, right? For the Twitter. Because I start when I start. It's whether you guys want to stay up to date.
Mad Bomber.
Wow. All right. The tone of the game has been set. Fairy Dragon?
Yeah, we play Fairy. Right.
So if he has a Glaive Zuka, we are probably dead. If he doesn't, then the next real danger is the 7-7. Oh, wow. Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
So we drop Spider Tank here?
Yep. Tank and kill the bomber. It's looking good. Yeah, who drafts that in Hunter? I guess, you know, he's planning on pushing that button a lot. Yeah.
Yeah.
Starting it now. He's got his priorities straight.
Drop 4-4.
7-7 and kill the beast?
Yeah.
Alright. And they're probably going to Belcher on 7. Fire Rally on 6. That means we can't Stormcrack next turn if we want to Fire Rally on 6, so that's probably worth it. We're going to need to draw something good then.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we could race him. He's had a head start, but seven. Oh wow,
We can do a lot of damage.
He's falling behind right now.
Then attack with it.
So here we're either using hero power or we're hexing the 2/4.
Do you think it's worth hexing the 2/4?
Not really, especially because high main's a card, so I think I just hero power here and push
Okay.
face for 10. Just
All
go.
we need is two more turns and then we win.
Yeah, pretty much. With the fire rally coming up, I think it's fine. It's because, we fire rally next turn, and then if he high mains on 6, then we can fire and then we can hex, so
Yeah.
it's fine. We can't hex Belcher, but I think he's going to be busy removing our cards because we're doing damage. Evolve, yeah, evolve's pretty good
Evolve.
here, guys. Evolve your 7/7
Never.
into a 4/4 or something. That's why it's a little bit of a counterintuitive. For, oh wow, really? Huh. I
He's
mean,
just going face.
well, he must have a ton of damage. That means we might just Belcher here. So, what I'm thinking is if we Belcher and trade our totem into a 1/1 and just jam 10 face, what's he gonna do about it?
It doesn't seem so bad.
Yeah, because I think if we go for the fire rally on curve, he might have lethal somehow. It's like maybe double kill command or something.
So we go Belcher, kill a 1/1 for
Yeah,
phase 10.
Belcher, kill a 1/1, jam 10 face, and just see whether he can deal with that. Because I'd be very surprised if he lethals us through this Belcher. I don't even think it's possible. Sure. Yeah, I mean, there's no way.
Still no.
And he's just dead on board. GG. Alright,
Yep.
so yeah, Aishi should have traded earlier. That was too crazy.
He was just going crazy. He had all those jobs he could have done.
Yeah, I thought he would have at least killed the tank. But yeah. He's confused, right? He's not used to someone doing more face than him, so. But this deck is pretty aggressive. Pew. Nice. GG guys, 5-0 with the crazy shaman deck. Look at that.
Crazy Shaman deck is the best kind of deck.
Oh yeah, crazy
Of
any game.
course.
So yeah, but a buddy of mine, Isherwood, had a crazy hunter deck with double Call of the Wild in arena, and that went 12-0. That was pretty sick.
Wow.
It was like the aggro decks with the great cards in arena, those are so much fun to play. Because Inconstructed is always like, they're gonna have healing, they're gonna have stall,
Yeah,
they're
of
gonna have
course.
board clears, and in arena just don't, they can't do anything, just kill them. Bully, oh come on guys.
We're not bullying
We
anyone.
earned that, right?
Yeah.
He challenged us to a smart duel and we accepted. That's all that happened
We're just establishing dominance here.
here. Definitely. So what do you want to do with this hand, Denny?
I'm not even sure we would keep everything. Maybe the silver hand?
I think we can do better than that. I think we throw it all, look for our
All the way.
axe, look for our two drops or horse riders, something
Yeah.
like that. 3 turns of 10 phase. Yeah, that's pretty much what happened. All right, so we picked up the horse rider. It's
It's
good.
probably our worst hand so far, though.
Yep. But, storm against Paladin is pretty useful because they tend to be, in storm range at least at one point in the game. And then Fire Rally is really good to get back on the board.
Yeah,
So I
he
don't
removes.
mind the hand. Like, depending on what we draw, of course, the hand might be playable. What if Call of the Wild was a rare? Then Hunter would be really good right now. So. Yeah, that card is so sick. I don't know what they were thinking when they made that card. It was just
It's
super.
good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's like, alright, so it's 5 phase, and then taunt, and then buff all the rest of my guys. Pretty okay. Alright, please lose that.
Oh, come on. Oh, shredders.
Rubber ducky. That might be worth it.
Do you think it's shocking yet?
So, what I'm thinking. I'm just trying to think what we play next turn. We might be passing. We might coin a horse rider.
Yeah.
Nah, it's probably fine passing it. I don't think it's
Okay.
worth it. If it was a 3/2, then it'd be worth it because it would kill it.
Yeah, of course.
But we're
But
still.
it's still like a 1/1. Oh boy.
Coin
You
horse
could
rider.
you think
Yeah, I think so. What are you thinking?
If we just hero powered way through 1 more 10 for lightning storm.
So if we hero power here, then we lightning storm out three.
Then we can. Oh, we don't actually have a follow-up to it.
Yeah, I think you have to play something here. I think you have to horse ride it a 3-2. And then maybe get a good storm next turn if he plays into it. Maybe your chalk his 2-3 to kill it off. Like it's gonna be a 2-1 here after the trade.
Yeah, he's gonna trade.
So we could just hero power Urchalk. Which is why I was thinking about Urchalking it on turn one, because I saw this kinda coming. But then at the same time, you know, it's not like we're missing out on too much here. Hero power Urchalk the 2-1, and then we can start off with 7-7s.
The first of many.
Against Paladin is kinda risky though, because Ulduman and Aldur.
Yeah, very annoying.
So I'm thinking if there's ever a world where we charge timer, and I don't think so, because I think we want to overload now so we can play our 6-6. Selena, thanks so much for the 4 months in a row. Appreciate that, man. Thank you for the 4 months of supporting the stream and for the co-ops, man. Appreciate that. Yeah, Mr. Bunny.
So we drop our 7-7 here.
This is where we could lose the game. I'm just thinking if there's any world where we charged hammer, hit something, and next turn just storm. Probably not, but you know, just thinking about it. Because if we drop 7-7 here and he goes like Seal of Champions on the 2-4, like bump bump, that's
Yeah.
probably game. Could also just charged hammer to kill the 2-1. Next turn drop the Belcher. And then play the Fire Rally on 6. Huh. It's not too bad either.
You'd prefer the Belcher play?
Yeah, I actually like that the more I think about it. I like the charged hammer and kill the 2-1. And then next turn, just drop the Belcher, hit the shield
Belcher.
off. And then we got the Fire Rally on 6. And then he never gets like an insane swing with a Seal of Champions or a buff or an
Yeah.
Aldur or an Older Man. That's great. He's playing slow. That's what we want.
Exactly. So we drop Belcher, hit the shield off.
Now there's a world where we could hit the 1-1 as well. Let's play the Belcher. That's happening. We're not using Storm yet. I think hitting the shield's probably still the safest. Let's do that. All right. Yeah, I like this. We took our time. We debated our moves, and we identified the risk. And you know, Ulduman was really bad. Aldur was really bad. Seal would have lost us the game on the spot, and now we have a chance. That's good. All right. He's gonna be able to draw cards. It's kind of bad. We might even lightning storm this, depending on what he does.
Terrifies.
So Fire Rally does clear the board, and we have a Fire Rally on the board. Well, not clear the board, but clears a 5-4, that's what I mean. So we'd have a 6-5 against 2-2, 1-2, and a 1-1, or we could hero power storm. Potentially don't take 5, but it might be a little bit too much.
Well, I mean, either way, we're taking.
Not either way, right? Because you could roll spell power and then high roll.
Yeah, that's why we don't. But if we play Ellie, we're still taking 5.
Yeah, I think Ellie the 5-4 and just take the 5 is probably correct. Put it out there and then next turn potentially storm. Because next turn we can storm and 7-7, that's a pretty good
Yeah.
turn. It's gonna be a close game no matter what. Nice.
We're super low already.
Yeah, we're getting the board, but it might be too late. He might be pushing too much damage. This is also a good test for an Ulduman or an Aldur. We'd probably use that here. All right. Yeah, we've played this game really good. I like this. We've made some tough calls and we've been rewarded. Because now we're gonna have a full clear board, but we're gonna overload into Oblivion. So we're taking 4 overload, so next turn's 4 mana, which means we get 7-7, but then we can't crack it on 9. Either way, I don't think we can get around Lightning Storm and the faces this turn, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's do that. Lightning Storm
Let's
faces, clear the board.
it.
Yeah, really rough game, but we did a good job. Okay, 9 HP, guys. At least we have a good hero power now.
Deal 2 damage? Yeah. He's on 30.
Yeah, he is on 30, so... I mean, even him, like, round. Having a true silver and going face here would probably be game.
Yeah. And we've used that one.
Oh, that's really good.
No.
That's really bad. Good.
I mean, you have to... Well, I mean, do you have to get rid of the 1-2? Probably you would...
Yeah, I think it's
just hero ping, power trade, yeah. And then
ping trade, play the cannon, and just hope, yeah. Right? He's probably gonna have lethal, like, but then again, we knew this game was gonna be super tough, and we really did we did the best we could, because if we dropped a 7-7, we'd have just lost on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, he's probably just gonna buff and kill us.
No, starting hand was pretty shitty.
Yeah. It's too bad. Like, an extra 5 live, and we probably win this game. I don't think we could have taken less damage. Maybe like minor inefficiency here or there, but... Oh yeah, that took a long time, didn't it? Okay.
He almost missed lethal, well, you know?
I don't mind that though, we played that well. I think we did the best we could there. It's important, guys. You know, when you play well, but you still lose, don't get upset. It's fine. That happens from time to time. Alright. Yeah, it was a pretty crazy paladin as well. He had it all as well, right? He had the seal, he had the Ulderman.
He did! Blessing at the end. The taunt, we can even chain into the 6-7.
Mm-hmm. He played this perfectly, Baby Rage, yeah. He needed exactly those cards to beat us.
Oh, we get rid of everything.
Yeah, we'll throw it all. We didn't have an axe, that was a problem. Let's work on that.
Wow.
Too bad it's a paladin as well. Don't be mean to the paladin, Shady. You have to count to 7. Poor guy.
A pass.
He was waiting for concede, but you didn't. Fine, buff and kill it is. Probably. What happened during the first 3 turns of the game? He played a Jouster and won, we passed,
yeah.
He played a Bone Guard, we coined Horse Rider, he played... What do you play on 3? Doesn't matter. So normally it's an easy Storm Crack, but that means no 7-7 next turn, and I don't think that's acceptable.
So you would Earthshock him?
I think we Hero Power and start with that, okay. See what happens. Yeah, I think Earthshock and trade, and then, because I mean, in this particular hand, there's no way we're not
playing
a 4 mana card, yeah. Right?
On 10-4.
Yeah. Silent Knight. Yeah, he played the Shush. Oh, okay. Okay. That's a slow start.
Sure. So you just drop a 7-7.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Drop a 7-7. Please, no Golden Man. One time. Come on. Elderman would be a Yeti as well, be a 4-5. Oh, yes! Doesn't have it, boys.
So we just Hero Power here?
Yep, Hero Power for sure, and I think we trade, because that's a little bit too perfect of a shape. Yeah. We don't want him to go, like, seal, kill our guy for free, that would be pretty bad. Sure.
Ooh.
It's fine, kill some totems.
I mean, yeah.
Like, we're still very far ahead.
Do you play 7-7 and X?
So next turn we're gonna have 7 mana, we're gonna have 5 mana if we overload for 2. So yeah. I think Hero Power 7-7 makes more sense, and then next turn we can play a 5.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's good. He's like, wow, really, dude? Two of them. It's like, you don't know half, my friend. There's more coming.
Unleash the second 7-7. Just wait till we get to the third one.
He's like, well, I have a dude. That's 2. Yeah, take that.
Oh. I sort of like Flame Tongue in the middle. Kill the 3/3 with the 1/1. Axing the 2/2 and going face.
I don't think that's bad at all. I'm just thinking, I'm just working out the overload, whether it makes sense. So next turn we're going to have 7 again then. 5 and 2 mm-hmm. kind of makes sense. There's no way we get a hero power out this turn as well right now.
No.
Yeah, I like it. Flame Tongue, kill the 3/3, axe the 2/2, 9 phase. He does know exactly half. Well, I mean, we have more, right? We got 2 Krakens, we got Fire Rally, we got 2 Hexes, Storm. It's a pretty insane deck, guys. If you haven't looked at the list yet, it's to the right. Just admire it for a little bit. You don't see these lists very often. Wow, his buffed up 7 drop's gonna trade with our 4 drop.
Yeah.
That's so unlucky. Alright, we have 4, 6, so even a spell power wouldn't do anything.
It wouldn't.
Think we're hero powering no matter what?
Yeah. Is it bad dropping the Warlord here? Trading in the 9/7, killing 2/2?
Yep, Warlord far left, then clear his board, and you know, it's just big boy after big boy, and this is another 7/7. it's pretty good. It's good timing. So guys, that's 3 7/7s, and he hasn't had an Ilderman or an Elder yet, so let's see if we can deal with it.
Still doesn't have one.
No, that's pretty good.
Kraken the 4/4.
Yeah, positioning is going to be a little tricky. Do we want to full clear his board?
I would probably leave the 3/3 up.
The thing is, a 3/3 can kill our Flame Tongue, though. That's kind of annoying. I think I would like the Kraken to the very far left, shooting the 4/4.
Okay.
Because I think we're threatening 2-turn lethal anyways. This is 18... 20, 22. Not quite. I think your phase goes into the 2/2.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would kill the 3/3 with our.
Okay, with the
9/7.
Yeah. Good phase to the 2/2.
I'm thinking if he has a chance to win, it involves us not trading there, and him doing like an MCT and kill your totem and something like that.
Yeah, I see.
That's fine. I guess for that reason, we could have traded off the totem as well, yeah. But then again, he could have still had, like, I don't know. He would need some crazy draws.
Mm-hmm. You could Stormcrack. Trade in the healing totem. I don't know if you would kill the 2/4, I would just go face with 18 damage.
Well, we're not killing him this turn, right?
No.
So I think the 9/7's okay to take the free kill into the 3/6.
Okay.
We'll start with that. And then our other 9/5 definitely goes face. And then we're either using Charged Hammer and our totem. I think I'm okay with that. Charged Hammer and Totem. Yeah, Charged Hammer and our Totem to kill that guy. Now I just probably put a Belcher on the right. I don't think there's much he can do after that. There is lethal if you evolve and it gives you charge. Yeah, but for the same, you know, thing, we might get a Doomsayer out of the Totem. Alright, that's game, dude. GG.
He's salty.
Because he's like, wow, you have lethal to a Sogoth. That's disgusting, dude. Yeah, we got some really good value out of these 9 damage minions, just killing everything for free. Yeah, when you're this far ahead, guys, there's no reason to evolve. Like, you might, like, maybe you kill him one turn earlier, but at the other hand, you might also evolve something really bad, and then he has a chance to win, so.
So we trade 9/5.
Yeah, we just trade one in the face with everything. It's like, oh, damn.
He should have just conceded.
I think the paladin was like, damn, he didn't miss it. I guess I'll concede. Yeah, I mean, I think we've all done that from time to time where, you know, just get so wrecked that you're not conceding immediately. You're just like, ah, this guy, you're just like busy ranting about it. But most of
Actually
the
gonna
time
go to the
that's
bathroom.
poor etiquette. All right, guys, this is a pretty sick shaman deck. This is going really well. The shamans all, I think shamans the most swingy class, right? Whenever you're drafting a shamanic, you're like, come on, man, give me a good deck, because shaman's so different in terms of decks. Like, we've all had that shaman deck where, you know, nothing works, and it's kind of like, ugh, you know, I don't have a ping, and I don't get on the board, I don't do anything. But this deck is so good that it feels like the opponent can't do anything. It's a really big swing between good and bad decks. Whereas a good mage deck or a bad mage deck, you can still work with a bad mage deck. Sometimes you kill him one turn earlier, sometimes Acid Maw comes up. Yeah, Acid Maw comes up and then he consecrates you or Matter Bombers you. That's, yeah, it's pretty sick.
All right, I'm back.
Hey, welcome back. Good to go. Tiber says you had the perfect answer to all of his big minions, and that was better big minions. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, 6-1 warrior. He's probably gonna have quite some weapons.
Oh, we send everything back.
Definitely, yeah. That's not a war axe. Let's go. I
Yeah,
guess Stormforged axe. Probably see the war axe on his end. Well, I mean, it's a curve. Could be better, but at least we're playing something in every turn.
2, 3, 4, yeah.
Ah, that's better curve.
Better 3-drop than 5-6.
Yeah, I mean, you really want to play this Farseer on 5, healing up your 7/7, so. Doesn't mean we're not going phase, though. But. Okay, better.
So we just drop ships, can.
Yep, definitely. See if he has the axe. If he has the axe, we just horse rider him in the face.
Seems good.
Yeah. I mean, the 3/3 would be terrible against the axe anyway, so.
That doesn't look like an axe.
No, he's a little bit too hesitant, right? He's like, well, maybe. Well, it looks like we're gonna be playing into a ghoul. Huh, maybe not.
Spider tank seems okay and just ignoring it.
It's either that or a horse rider kill it. It depends on how scared we are of the mech discount. But, you know, he could coin a shredder already, so I think I'm okay with the
Yeah.
tank in phase. Yeah.
Okay.
Because if he has a ghoul, he's still killing his own guy. That's fine. Yeah, and if we had Horse Rider double trade, Ghoul would clear the board. That'd be bad. And Ghoul's so common. It's probably more common than a Shredder, even though he's got a Mech Warper in his deck.
King's
Sure.
Defender. Coin.
Elven Archer? Oh, Blood to Ichor. That's quite good.
Yeah, it's pretty good. We drop 7/7, kill 2/2.
Yep, 7/7 kill the 2/2. And then we have the choice between Horse Rider or healing next turn. So at least this coin is gone, so he's playing on curve from here on out. Or
That's
maybe not.
pretty good. Oh, I don't know. What do you think about trading 6/6?
If we trade it and heal our guy up, it's at 4.
Yeah.
So face and his 2/1 into it seem like a reasonable price for him to pay. I mean, for us, right? Yeah, I'm okay with that. I'd kill the 6/6 and heal it up. Because it seems like he's expecting to kill it off with a Mech Warper like this, so we can deny him that. You can still execute, right? You could execute this and then
Yeah, he
face into the
could.
3. Shady, how did your 12-0 quadruple Barbara Rogan up yesterday? Actually, only 8 error. But yeah, we got like super memed. We got like, well, our tank got BGH'd and other things. Oh, he's got a ghoul? Sure. But the main problem was that we didn't have any taunt or healing or AoE. So we're actually really vulnerable to just getting rushed. A lot of guys just rushed us down. Perfect, right? You're pretty good against this game, Denny. I like it.
Maybe you should just switch to Arena.
Yeah, I think Arena suits you very well. Arena agrees with you. Could also be beginner's luck, right? It's just beginner's trying luck to pull you in and then, you know, you get wrecked.
That's true.
Yeah, I was going to totem and horse rider, but this is quite a bit better.
What do you think about Tongue, Horse Rider, Hero Power?
Yeah, I like the Hero Power. Let's see what that is, and then we have some more information. If that's a Taunt Totem, I'm totally on board. It might still be the best play. So I think we Flame Tongue first, and then push the 8 phase.
Yeah.
And then we Horse Rider and steal the buff from the Fire Rally, and then kill the 3-4. So it's a little bit...
Okay, yeah, I understand.
It's a bit more awkward for him to BGH then as well. Should he have it, he'd have to kill the horse guy first. While the totem's active, so it's pretty awkward for him. Okay, yeah, that's good. Oh, we got Earth Shock for the Psychotron, so... Probably just lethal, right? No, close. The 1-1's preventing lethal.
Yeah, the 1-1.
Feels bad, man. Okay. Because of that, are we doing something different?
I mean, we still go for it, then we can just crack in next turn.
I think the Earth Shock on the shield always happens.
Yeah, Earth Shock on the shield.
That's definitely happening.
Is trading 6-5 the 4-1
going?
Oh
wait, do we have it anyway? No. The buff shifts to the Fire Alley. We got him. So the 4-1 goes into the taunt, then the buff.
Oh,
shifts
we do,
to the...
Yeah.
We got it. And then the horse rider.
Because
I died. Yeah, guys, I saw it. Relax, I got it, boys. I got it. I can do math sometimes. Sometimes. So, you know, they'll call me out on that when I don't.
We would have figured it out anyway when it died, you know.
Yeah. But the thing is, we may have preserved it, like to trade into the Psychotron or something. But
yeah.
We're probably not gonna miss that. Chat lethal for once. Yeah.
For once.
Good job, guys. Good job. You got it.
We were just testing you.
Yeah, definitely. It's like the Pink Panther movie. Just we'll test you. I'm not sure if you saw that, like Inspector Clouseau.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Lots of your first time co-ops go 12. It's like you do it on purpose. Yeah, I just draft a sick deck every time, man. It's,
of course.
Pretty much it's my policy, right? It's actually me just baiting people into Arena. Play a sick deck. Hey, that's been a while. How you doing, X? How you doing, buddy?
The X. So we send everything back apart from the X.
Yep, just keep the X looking good. All right, so another 2 mana card and we're set.
Well, not quite.
Potentially.
We can still get it.
Yep, for sure. Shady should keep a chat rank counter. Every time we call the right play, we gain a rank. You gain a star, let's put it like this. Right?
A star.
And every time you miss lethal or you call lethal when it's not, you drop a star.
So we just X that?
Most likely.
Oh, nice.
So there is also a world where you Earth Shock this to then Spider Tank on 3. Mm-hmm. I don't think so. I like the X, so I think we X him here.
We can still draw 2 drop easy.
Can we get a tracker on screen for chat lethals? Oh man,
ta-da.
So good at the game. Yeah, I like it.
Oh, screen you shall receive.
Shady Bunny, can you tell me more about good gaming? Well, as a matter of fact, I can, Badly Dressed Onion. Glad that you're interested. So we're sponsored by Good Gaming, guys. It's a social networking site for gamers. Make sure to check it out. They also host tournaments, amateur tournaments for free, but you can also join the pay-to-plays to win some prizes. So, to 7-7 or not to 7-7? That's pretty much the question here.
It's quite tough, you know?
Yeah, I think we just drop it.
Yeah, of course.
Well, I mean, the thing is, like, the sap on the Yeti is much better for us than the sap on the 7-7. Yeah. So there is a reason to not do it. But I think because you got the tank ready, I think we're good.
Yeah, my three jumps to come out of it.
Good. Hard turn? Yeah, I know. But it's, you know, it's definitely something that, if you think about it, the Yeti might be better, but I think it's just too much. It's too much fun to just drop the 7. Yeti also dies to Shadow Strike, which would be annoying.
That's almost up.
The rogue's just traumatized. He's like, or maybe he's just slow rolling it. He's savoring the moment. He's like, oh, I'm
savoring. This step's gonna be good. He's really not doing anything.
Wow, he might just be this disgust. Oh, look at him! Look at him! Oh, look at him! The bastard!
He even roped for it. I see how it is.
Oh well.
Yeah, let's just drop Spider Tank.
Yep, drop the tank. Alright, we'll get into this. It's better to drop it before Assassinate turn. I don't necessarily agree, Daya. You could probably bait out the sap. It's kind of sad that I expected that.
Yeah.
I've seen it before. I think it's more people coming from Constructed and just having a hate for Face Shaman and just, you know, like... But I mean, Shaman in Arena is an honorable class, guys. Come on.
Honorable
smart class.
4-7-7.
Oh, we're going to Earth Shock that. Oh, you know what to do, right, Denny? That's the last thing we do in that turn, right? We're going to just float one mana the entire turn and then boom. So, probably 7-7 number 2?
Yeah.
So that means next turn we're going to have 5 mana. Another 7-7 is possible, sure. All right, so 7-7 on the far left, 3 face, and then we just pause the entire turn.
Like, so how's your day been, Shady?
It's pretty good. Like maybe we can even do it worse and just like hover over the shield with our weapon. And it was like, yeah, maybe I'm gonna hit it. Hey, he started this, guys. He started this.
Should we?
Maybe. Be a master league. No, day's been really good. Like we had that 12. I mean, you saw that crazy mage run, right? That was an insane run.
Yeah.
And then we had a 12 win druid before that as well. All right, let's just Urchuck him. I don't have time for this shit.
Wait. Yeah, there we go.
Gotta wait for the rope, right?
Why are all the decks?
Oh, you missed the previous deck, Uncle Phil. That was really scrapping for 7. That one was a hard fight we got there.
10 out of 10 BM, of course.
Sorry guys, it had to be done, right? He started it. He roped the sap. Oh, another one?
Oh, no, shams. No. Because I didn't use the top deck one. I used the one he sat, so he doesn't know we have another one in hand.
Yeah, see guys, those are the real strats. That's actual useful stuff, right? Make sure you don't do that.
But he'll just concede when we play other 7-7. Easy.
Just make him annoyed. My eyes are open.
Well, we probably trade the 3-3 with... So many.
Another set. I mean, there's also a world where you Yeti and then evolve to save your tank. And then next year you dub 2 7-7s.
Oh, I like that.
That's not bad, is it?
I like Yeti trade evolve.
Yeah, I like that too. It's hard to get good use out of evolve anyways. So.
You ready for this?
Yeah, let's go.
Thanks.
I mean, okay. If he doesn't have AoE, that's pretty good. Could evolve before Yeti as well. Well, we got a 5-5 out of it. And I don't like giving the rogue spare parts for our 7-7s. Like, a free spare part would be really bad. I guess if he drops Skulkers in the
That's super annoying.
If he doesn't get past this guy, I think we're good. If he like drops an Abyss as well, I'd be pretty annoyed. Ah, poison. At least he takes a face damage thing.
We're just dropping double sunset on here.
Yeah, and I think with that draw, our face goes face as well. Yep. You better be running out of shit, Lyra. Come on.
Yeah, hopefully. You're playing right into Vanish.
Stupid Spider Tank didn't become a 7-7. I know, guys. Can we talk about how stupidly good his deck is for a moment?
It is.
Sap, Poison, Shadow Strike, Drake, Skulker.
Skull. Mm-hmm.
Really? Really.
Next up, Drake. Eviscerate?
Oh, what? Stop doing things! Alright, at least that didn't do enough, right? He's still one off clearing both.
Yeah.
But holy crap. Come on, just put your face into the 7. What's the worst that could happen?
Nothing, right?
Yeah.
It's not like we can kill him or anything.
Oh, what a pussy! Look at that. Guys, he's pussying out already. Prep? Nah. Again! All right, 7-7.
Wait, we go for it, right?
Yeah, 7-7 in face with everything, including a weapon. This guy is like, what the fuck? Alright, so this is the reason why we didn't pick the Crackle, just because the memes, right? To be able
the
to
memes.
Do this. The chat saw this coming. The chat
yeah, we have four faceless in the deck.
Yep. They're coming out loud, guys.
Tensure is fine.
Okay. And I mean, he didn't have a betrayal earlier, so unless he drew that with the fan or his current draw, it's going to be pretty hard to deal with this.
This guy just shat his pants.
I think he's more just annoyed, really annoyed. This is like Jirax's hero power, yeah. It's better, it's a 7-7.
Fair and balanced, I agree. It's like totally fair and balanced.
Well, they had to do something, because Shaman was in the dumpster previously.
Yeah. Okay.
Does he have a buff for the Drake? Does he not have to take the 7? Because we have lethal if he doesn't. The totem and the hammer.
Mm-hmm.
Unless he double trades, but I can't see him double trading here. That seems stupid. Oh, maybe he's roping, you know, like an eviscerate or something? For 5? No, he's actually lagging.
He didn't.
Okay. GG, guys.
Oh.
We can't BM him with the funnel kicks, unfortunately. Yeah, that's all it takes to win games, guys. Just back to back to back to back. 7-7.
Yes. 42 stats and 3 turns to double mana.
I guess we played 5-7-7, right? Because you said 2.
Yeah, that's true. He did set.
That's all right, guys. 5-7-7s, no worries. Yeah, I mean, if they're actually paying attention to Arena and they want to fix Priest, I'm really curious what kind of sick shit they're gonna give Priest for the next expansion. Because right now it's in a really bad spot.
Oh, we sent back everything.
Yeah, I throw it all.
It's not too bad. 2, 3, 4. Well, we need another 2 drop.
Job's done.
Mistakes were made.
Yeah, Botti is a little confused because all the opponents are known guys, so don't pay too much attention to what we're playing against.
Oh, we just played the Axe here, right?
We just played the Axe. Alright, I'll boost the mic a little bit, guys, but not quite sure.
Wait, is mine louder than yours?
No, they were just saying that my mic was getting more and more quiet, but I could be Hangouts doing something weird.
Maybe.
Alright, give me a second. Let me sure. Well, I mean, we can just hear a power and pass.
Yeah,
there's not much to do. Let me have a look-see. Because he might just randomly turn the mic down. Nope. We're good.
What did you guys lose to? Did we lose to the Paladin?
Yeah, we lost to the Paladin that had the Older Man, the Seal, the Consec, like, he had all the things he needed to.
Oh, that's annoying. Do we drop our 7-7?
We do, because next turn we have Horse Guy.
Yeah.
And we kill it, so there is a world where you preemptively hit that, but I don't think I would have done it anyway. Just because, you know, then next turn we could hit something else and use our Horse Guy into the 4. But it's too risky, because if he has, like, something for the taunt and then trades in the 4 and a buff or whatever.
Yeah.
It's pretty unlikely, though. What could he do for 4 mana to kill the taunt and buff this and trade this in?
Probably not a lot, actually.
Yeah. You can't coin Skulker, that'd be one of the things. Yeah, I'm actually going to get punished for that, because otherwise I would have been able to double trade. Holy... Can people stop doing that?
Yeah, it would be good. Damn. Well, we double trade into the 4-4.
Well, you could Lightning Storm and clear the
Lightning board. Storm and, yeah, exit, that is...
Next turn we're going to have 4 mana that we can drop a 7-7.
That seems quite good.
If we Horse Rider and kill the 4-4 here, then he stabs the Horse Rider, pushes another 3 face. We don't have to overload, but what are we going to do with 6 mana next turn? Drop a cannon as well. It's close. It's really about how much we value this storm.
But do rogues ever fill up?
Yeah, they definitely fill the board. Yeah, I'm actually okay with the Horse Guy and kill the 4-4.
Horse Guy and kill 4-4.
Seems like rogue at 7 plus wins tends to have sap. It's nuts, right?
Probably more than one sap.
Yeah. So anyways, how's the how's the volume right now, guys? Can you hear me properly or not? I might just play into the storm here.
Oh, we went... I think we tried here.
Let's see what we draw first. So we need to high roll one of his guys. If we do, we get to play a cannon as well. I don't think we want to go for the hero power. Yeah, I think I'll go for the storm here. I think they're playing the 7-7s out just because of the Cobra. Volume's good, okay. Better. Yep.
So we kill it, play ship's cannon.
Yeah, exactly. Alright, so the hold on the storm actually worked really well. That's good.
Yeah.
We're at 17 health though, so. But we have the Hex. If he plays a big minion, he could regain some tempo.
Cool.
Sure.
Will we just drop the faces?
If that wasn't a Trog, I think I'd be leaning to Vendor, kill his guy, and evolve. But the evolve will buff the Trog. JCity, thanks so much for subbing 9 months in a row. I appreciate that, man. I don't think there's a world where we're not killing that ghoul, so let's start with that.
Yeah, so trade weapon in there.
Yeah. If we 7-7 here, next turn we're gonna have 6 mana. Yeah, it's probably alright to drop the 7-7 here.
Okay.
Yep, that's the one he sapped, right? I think. Yeah.
Yeah, no. Maybe.
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 But I think if he saps it, he puts it back on the right, so yeah, it should be. So here he'd need to have removal for the 7-7 to be in a good spot, otherwise he could probably still manage.
Okay. He doesn't.
So he's just pushing 3. So we get to kill the questing.
So we trade in the questing.
Every time. Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Next turn we're gonna have 9 mana. If we overload, we're gonna have 7 mana.
Yeah.
We're probably going to need to Hex next turn, so that's going to leave us with 4 mana. So we could technically get the 7-7 out.
No.
Unless we're afraid of dying, but he's got 4, so we need 9. Tinker's is 6, so we need Tinker's Abyss or something. Let's hero power and see what we get. If,
okay.
If we get a taunt, I think we're really safe with the 7-7.
Yeah, we could own one.
I think we still 7-7, because... The funnel cakes is just a lot less power. Yep. I'd put it on the far right for the trailer. Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I think here we're playing more around his cards than our totem. I mean, if he has it, he has it. That's just very unlikely burst in arena. Because, you know, if you're not dead to a tank, I think you're usually fine. Okay. Totally okay.
Yeah.
Oh, ciao. Yes. Very good. It means we might be greedy and just use our face to play the shield. Or not.
Not even sure what I would do. Would you Earthshock 3-4? Probably get rid of both his minions.
What to do? I guess we can't really lose if we don't take the damage here.
Mm-hmm.
Are we ever evolving?
Probably not. I don't know.
You could put everything really low. I think you Earthshock the Psychotron. I agree with that, by the way.
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, I think you you could put the 7-4. Let's put the 7-7 into the 5-4.
Okay.
7-4 into the 3-3. And then refreshment vendor evolve. I think that's fine. We still heal, so we're pretty unlikely to die. You could also Spider Tank Hero Power evolve, but I think I wanted to heal for sure.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Oh, that's an insane evolve, yeah. It's really good. I'm pretty sure that this turn wasn't optimal, but I think given, you know, the time constraint, we did a pretty decent job there. Yeah, go ahead, dude. It's gonna be pretty hard to outvalue us at this point. Because now our hero power becomes better than his hero power.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, all the healing. Look at it. I'm just getting healed up.
She's giving it to us.
Very nice. Yeah, we're equal health as him. Oh, that's pretty good. I don't think the charged hammer does too much, so I think the hero power to tank and the warlord's probably good enough, right?
Yeah, hero power is by the tank warlord.
Yep. Does that mean we just let our guys heal? Because he's not really threatening to kill us.
We take a face first.
Yeah, I think we're just playing around betrayal, so I put the tank on the far right and the warlord on the far right again and just line him in the face. That was a really good totem roll. That makes it awkward for him. Too bad we've already used our storm. We could heal with the Halazil.
Yeah, but we never knew we'd get it.
Sure. I mean, the health is fine. I mean, we're so far ahead on the board. We should be good. You're 7-7 evolved into 5-5s. Yeah, but they both are like 2 or health.
2 health. Yep.
I think one guy even had 1 health. So.
There you go. So we're putting the 5-4 into the 2-4.
I think, you know, are we? I don't think we're hexing this turn, right?
Probably not.
So I think we're fine just hero powering, seeing what we get.
Okay.
And then, 7-7 on the far left for sure. Grip the hammer. We could use.
You could just leave the 4-4 up.
Yeah, I think the 5-4 kills the taunt and face and the tank kills the 3-5. And then you just put 8 face.
Yeah.
That still sets up Lisa. And that's a pretty clean clear as well. Alright. Yeah, this deck is so sick. Just the amount of quality big minions we can play in a short span of time is just nuts.
I love it.
And GG. Well, he's dead to the two big guys, so
yeah.
What you can do here, my friend.
He's got Deathwing now, bro.
Well, I mean, the frog's at the ready, so Deathwing is good for him, but you know, when you know your opponent doesn't even guarantee win off a Deathwing, you're in a pretty good spot.
Alright, let's keep going.
Yeah, 9-1. This is probably one of the fastest runs I've had as well. It's just so fluent.
Shaman.
Yeah, very smooth. Very smooth. Don't forget to give Denny a follow as well after this run, guys. She mainly plays Constructed, but
yeah.
You know, maybe we can pressure her into an arena from time to time.
Peer pressure, Dan's game.
Well, I've been told that if the ladder is a still bigger, then
yeah.
Venture into arena from time to time. So.
Yes. We get rid of everything.
Yes.
This is not all
three
drops.
Axe or horse guy.
Oh, God.
Or, yeah, it's. That's probably our worst hand up till now.
Yeah. We actually have nothing we can play.
Yep.
This girl from UK. Yeah, I live in London.
Oh, easy there, H. Hey, nice. Yep. He's gonna hit it and ping it, but at least that, you know, takes his turn two away. Oh.
No.
Sure. We can punish that. Oh, we can punish that so hard. We can use the Flame Tongue, free kill this guy, and then evolve. Oh, that's
let's
so
do
good.
It.
Yeah, let's kill his Amani for free.
So we Flame Tongue.
Yep.
There's Amani and evolve.
He would have been in such a good spot if he just free killed. Ooh, that's terrible. He free kills it. Oh well, I guess, you know, he kills it less free than a Flame Tongue Totem, but...
Yeah.
Still, with our hand, this is probably a really good spot, right? We probably shouldn't ask for more.
I mean, it's okay.
Yeah, we're gonna get a hit from this Shadow Fiend as well, so... Get a 7-7 for 3. Oh.
Not quite.
Huh. So if we want, we can get rid of the Flame Waker.
Yeah.
It's pretty awkward though.
Would you trade an axe into it?
So if we land a healing totem, this is quite good. But at the same time, it'll just trade off as 2-1. So I guess we're just playing funnel cakes and killing the 2-1.
Yeah.
Is there a world where we're going face ourselves? I think the funnel cakes come down, right? Let's try
with
that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think it's bad killing the 2-1.
Yeah, I think so too. I think that otherwise you might cast a small removal. On the other hand, we are a pretty facey deck, right? So 3 damage in the end. So how does he punish us here? Dark Iron Dwarf, trade the 3. We axe, kill this guy. I'd go face. I think our deck, especially against Mage, needs the face damage.
Okay.
It's pretty close, but I think because you have the axe in your hand, you're all right.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever won or lost off a Deathwing? Oh, a lot of times, Gladiators. I think at least 3 times each.
Because of
a Deathwing. Yeah, just... I think I've lost to Deathwing more than I've won with it. Not scarier, sure.
I lost to Deathwing in a ladder. But it was a tempo dragon, and I don't know why he had a Deathwing in his deck.
Was it like Face Warrior? Like
Yeah. With giant, they're not supposed to run like Deathwing.
It seems like a weird combination. Hero power looks alright. I don't think we're hexing. So we got kind of punished, but at the same time, he played turn 4, Lance Carrier Ping. I'm so fine with that. Like, maybe we even made him play bad by giving him this option, right?
Yeah, maybe.
Right. So Axe and Kill the Waker looks very good with this totem. I think that happens a lot where people see you going face and like, oh, I have to punish this. How can I do this? And then they start doing like a bad move and you should just accept that. You know, you should probably play a 4-drop instead. Just take the trade. Well, there's pretty much only good cards ahead from this point. 4-7-7s, Fire Alley, another Kraken, another Hex.
Yeah. Would you hex the 3/4?
I think so. I think we're gonna lose too much tempo otherwise. So I think I'd hero power here. And then hex his guy. Probably kill it with the 3 and then
take the 2.
That, yeah. So we can heal our final cakes out of flamestrike for the next turn.
Seems good.
Yeah. Can't use
how the axe got discounted. We got the card from Evolve.
Yeah, the 3/3 for priest 3/3. It's called horror or something, or no, Shadow Fiend. That's it.
Oh. So I would probably I don't know. I would face this. I don't know if I would play Spider Tank. And I would trade the 2/3.
You could also kill the 5/5 if you want to make his flame strike worse. But I think we're actually in a good enough position that I would just kill the 2/3 with our 3/4. We'll start with
that.
And then, do we ever just Jormungar here or not?
It might be okay.
He still clears it with flame strike. That's my only concern. I think we're... So if we Jormungar now, then we can't overload next turn because we have to crack it on 9. We can't Jormungar then.
So maybe it's better to play now so we overload, we can play
Capture
next turn.
I like
the
hero power and the faces. Yeah.
Okay.
You can't play Captured next turn no matter what because you only have 6 mana. That's the thing. And then just pass. But I think we're doing slow value route, and then next turn we have to find something in combination with the tank to play.
We're all top deck 5-drop.
Yeah, Zeri, but if you overload now, you can't play your Jormungar next turn either. Oh, he's got the value for it, alright. Okay. We can match that. Oh, we definitely can match that.
So we axe the 2/2.
Well, I think our 7/7 always kills a 5. We'll start
with that.
And then there's also the option of killing the 5/5 here, right? With the 3.
With the 3 in face.
I don't think that's good, though. I think I would even use the 3/3 to free kill the 2. And then just hero power and heal our 7/2 back up with the Farseer. Like, take it really slow, really value-oriented here. Then our guy goes back up to 6 as well.
Yeah,
because we had a really slow start. I don't think we want to out-tempo him. I think we'll just take it slow, try to take his flame strike at this. Like, I mean, he's probably got a flame strike. He's 9 wins, so
just. He's an endless build up more board.
Yeah, like I'll try to hero power every turn, just try to get that value and just make him flame strike. I mean, this is a pretty good flame strike. You can't ping the 7/6. If you could have pinged the 7/6, I don't think we should have played this, but because he can't ping here and flame strike. Crazy.
This is not a flame strike.
Okay, well, what world triari came last that guy?
To trade again?
Oh, in that world. Yeah, again's pretty good.
Sure.
We don't always have to crack in here because we could use our face in the 3.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Face 3, and then I don't know what I dropped. Maybe still cracking, but
so it's whether we want to save 7 life here, because either we're playing Jormungar hero power kill his guy and then we're at 15, or we crack in his guy, trade our guy, and we're at 22. I think we can probably take the damage. I think I'm okay killing it and then playing Jormungar hero power.
Okay.
I'm just seeing what he does. Being able to deal 4 damage to something seems useful, especially, you know, if he Krakens himself. Right, and... might see his removal come out.
Yeah, it's a 5/9. Mechanical Yeti. Double Mechanical Yeti. I mean, I know how we can match that.
Well, I think we always kill one Yeti. Because then if we get Reversing Switch or plus 1 damage, it's actually really good because we can crack another Yeti.
So we kill one of them.
Yep.
Stop.
So I don't think we crack in that. And if we're not cracking that, I think we're hero powering. So let's start with that.
Playing double
7-7? Yep, level 7-7s. Right. And positioning wise against mage at this point, I'd probably just put the 7-7s, you know, at opposite ends, so he can't just cone and freeze all the good stuff.
Ah, okay, yeah, I forget about kind of cold.
That's okay. I mean, it's if he has it here, it's annoying. Though we can probably bring it back.
Oh, Reaver.
Okay. Someday I'll be just like you. There's a freeze. Oh. Let's go for it. I'm thinking our 7-7 kills is Yeti. Start with that.
Yeah, I was thinking Yeti and then the 5-4. I'm not sure about the 5-4 actually.
We'll see what spare part we get. I'm kind of just hoping for a freeze part here, really. Plus one
attack.
Doesn't quite do it.
What if we trade the 5-4, play Belcher, and then stealth our 5-4?
Yeah, that's what I'm leaning towards. I think that's great.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, our 5-1, okay. Right?
It's gonna be oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Just to make sure we're on the same page. Belcher probably better than a Thunderbluff Valiant on this particular board. Although it's Greenwich Totem would have done something as well. No, we couldn't have hero powered. Yeah. Yeah, Belcher definitely better in this particular case. So I milled a flame collar, we milled another faceless. Okay. So he's keeping up with our faces, guys. He's got three of them as well. He got double freezes, no.
Wow, that's pretty lucky.
Oh wow. Yeah, this guy's going toe to toe with our value.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the 5-1 looks pretty nice going into the 8-5.
Yeah, I think we just try to mill his entire deck here so he doesn't have a draw left.
So we War Leader. Spider Tank, War Leader.
Yeah, we Spider Tank and Warlord. And then we Whirling Blades the 7-7. And we just trade our 5 into the 8-5, our 8 into the 8, and one face, and then that should be it. He's got no more cards left. Yeah. I think that's fine. That better be a really good card, mage. Alright. Nice. This deck, yeah. Or his deck. What was in his deck, guys? Was it some crazy shit that we milled?
Yeah, it's quite a lot. The double fell Reaver.
Oh, he had two Reavers? Okay, let's see.
Did I see that wrong?
That he got milled. Yeah, I didn't pay attention to the mills at all. So you're going to know a lot better than I do. Yeah, I was thinking about cracking for most part there, but it doesn't make any sense, right, guys? We can just clear all his cards. So I usually say don't focus too much on the milling, but if we can literally kill all his cards, you know, it's pretty good. Troll versus Gina. Belcher, Bomb Lobber, Tree Faceless. Yeah, quite a solid deck.
We get rid of everything?
Yep. Might be the same guy, but we can't see it anymore with the unknown bug.
Is it bugged for every person you play?
Yeah, yeah, everyone's unknown right now in Arena.
That's annoying.
It is, for sure. Yeah. And it's been for quite a while. Guys, how long has the unknown bug been in the Arena right now?
They use hero power.
Yep. At least it's a pretty high quality hand, right? We've got Horse Rider with the Yeti, and then Fire Alley on 6, so we just need something for 5, maybe an Evolve. And he's playing kind of slow himself.
So we just drop Horse Rider into face?
Yep. Don't worry, Horse Rider.
Smoke.
Because, you know, Pink Cream here is kind of weird, so I don't see
it. Yeah, because you can't kill it.
After the last patch, yeah, okay, I know a lot now. Like, what's the date? Oh, he did ping, okay. Okay with that.
Coin
bomber, go.
What?
Wow. Seems like a great order.
Oh.
Huh. Yeah, 7-7, right? Yep. We don't get the Yeti next turn, but if we don't play it this turn, we don't get the Fire Rally on 6, so.
That's true.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
Trade the 2-1.
No. My
That's
7-7.
Annoying.
No.
Right. Even more annoying. Oh, we just trade hero power.
Yeah, trade hero power. A slow turn, but we've got an incredibly sick like follow-up. So he could trade the 1-1 flame cannon ping. That's probably one of his best clears. He could also just fireball pin and trade. Yeah.
Yeah, fireball trade.
That's okay.
So we're just dropping fire at me.
Probably. Because if we overload now, we can't play it anyway. So yeah, fireball is good. Oh man, we have 2 Krakens. This guy's gonna get so salty value-wise. He's like, yeah, I'm a mage, you could probably just outvalue. I'm like, nope, Kraken, Kraken.
2 Krakens.
Oh, please don't.
Nope.
Okay, sure, no worries.
That does nothing.
I hate it when that card beats me, because it's so annoying. Oh, we can't kill it for free and then evolve, that'd be great.
It would, but...
Huh. Almost tempted to go like 7-7 and roll a totem or something.
Well, that's what I was thinking. If you 7-7 hero power.
Yeah, let's hero power, see if we get something good. Yeah. I don't think we have to play the Earmonger. Alright, 7-7, 6 base. That's good. Because Flame Strike doesn't really change too much. It's not really a board you want to Flame Strike anyway.
It's quite weak. Because the 6-5 still alive, 7-7.
He shoots, he misses. Oh, we're gonna get such a sick evolve here.
So we trade the 6-5 into the Drake.
Yeah, the thing is, do we even evolve the Yeti, or do we just evolve first? Because Yeti's a pretty good drop. Or do we want to deny him the spare part? So 6-5 into Drake, 7 face for sure. There's no way we're missing Lethal right now. That's
no.
All right. So are we evolving a Yeti or not? I think so. I think we evolve the Yeti. I think he has
the Yeti.
Yeah, I think the spare part's probably better for him because we're about to be on the board.
Yeah. Okay.
That's so crazy. Everything's better because we don't want the spare part on the Yeti anyway, so that's really good.
Thunderbluff, 6-8 taunt. I'm good with this.
You could have traded the 7-2 over evolving it. Yeah, but that's not good, right? You want to evolve it. Yeah, let's just crack in his face. If he can't heal himself, then he's dead to the next cracker.
Job's done.
Sir, you are disgusting. I know, guys, this has been insane. Oh, look. Still dead on board.
We do it anyway.
Well, I mean, in this win bracket, it's fairly likely that, well, not fairly, but it's somewhat likely that we play him again. So usually you don't show it, but it's fine.
Okay.
It's fine. We just, our deck is so good, he can win. We'll take him on. He's probably not going to want to queue up straight away anyways, because who would like to go like, yeah, I'll just play this guy again. All right, so you can wait a second, Benny.
Okay.
I'm gonna put up some diggies. So I'm not sure if you've
okay.
you're familiar with this, but whenever we're at 11, guys, we put up some diggy diggy hole. You guys spam your shady diggies in the chat. Help us dig for some more gold, some more rewards. Help us get to 12 with this disgusting shaman deck. It's
it's disgustingly amazing.
It's really good. Some would even say it's incredible, guys. So yeah, you can queue it up, Benny.
Okay.
Guys, if you're not a subscriber, you can still partake. Just use your favorite emote and slap a pickaxe at the back. And let's just go. Let's get this baby home. Digging time, guys. Oh yeah. Oh whoa! Warrior versus Shama for the final.
Yeah.
That doesn't
look at that X. Awesome.
Ooh, we're getting a good start.
So I would just keep the horse rider and the X.
Yeah, we'll do that too.
Okay.
Fives could have been better, but so I'm assuming he's got a quite a long deck.
We just end here?
Yep, we just pass. Just like we have quite the shaman. Playing versus Hafu confirmed. Only Hafu plays Warrior and everything.
Against 11 wins.
I don't think Hafu would skip our turn 2, it's just a good one.
So we just axe up here?
Yeah, we just axe up. Put it down. If he has the Uzi, he has the Uzi, so it'd be annoying.
It'd be really annoying.
Whoa! He must have like the biggest.
Are we facing Control Warrior here?
Well, I think we mirror his move and just hero power there, right? Next turn we can qualify the point.
If only we had a good start, he would be wrecked right now.
Well, maybe he's just kind of reactive.
More reactive, so, I guess so.
Get to Icar and stuff.
Yeah.
Horse rider and killer, but I think I'm more leaning towards the refreshment vendor.
I was thinking the vendor as well.
But what if we didn't Arcanine Reaper's our guy? That's pretty awkward.
Is Arcanine Reaper pretty popular?
Yeah.
Oh gosh.
See Reaper, pick Reaper. Yeah, I think for that reason we just horse guy and kill it. I mean, if he wants to go,
okay.
It's okay. I think our deck is so sick for the late game, we just have to not give him any swing turns. Just don't make his weapons good. Because, I mean, he may have had a ghoul in his hand and he just didn't want to play it for, you know, just for tempo.
Sometimes you want to play it for tempo.
I would probably play it, but he knows his deck better probably, so if he just has a sick value deck, you know, I want to keep it.
Mm-hmm. Oh. These 3 health mains are super annoying.
Yeah. Level 2 health, maybe. We're all too late.
Too late.
If we play it now, then we're gonna have 4 mana next turn.
We can play Vendor.
If we play the Beltry, he kills it. If we play the Vendor, he kills it. Yeah, I guess we got the 7-7. 5 mana 7-7. Still not the worst. Still have our coin, so we could go up to 5, coin the Belcher if we want to.
That's true.
We could hex if he plays a big minion. He could use his face into this and execute.
Did heal that?
He didn't have a blood to recoup.
What? Did you hex the 6-6?
Definitely considering it. Better play with to just turn it another way. Kill it 3, kill it 2.
That might not be bad.
Because I feel like this guy's deck is so slow, he must have Obsidian Destroyer and stuff.
Okay.
So I feel like just another 7-7 here. Go with 3 and face down the 2 and just...
Let him do his stuff.
Because he could Ghoul and trade here, but he loses his board.
Mm-hmm.
And he takes 7 and we get healed, so...
Yeah.
With our deck, we can just play beginning this next turn, so... we got 6 mana next turn with coin, or 5 without, so we can still just belch him and play it back in. So
yeah, that seems good.
Yeah, I think the key to beating this guy is not playing too fast, because I think he's going to have amazing reactive tools, so I think he's going to be able to hold this off. So if we don't get ahead of ourselves and just, you know, keep reacting to what he does, our hero power in the end is just going to win. And I mean, our cards are pretty hard to outvalue, like 2 Krakens.
It's a lot.
Oh, look at that.
Clockwork Knight, wow. Knight Hunter.
We could do it again, though.
I mean, you can kill 1-1, you can trade the 5-5, could drop a Belcher.
I think that trade the 1-1 with our face, kill the 5-5 with the 7 is probably right. It's the most value I got cards.
Alright.
And then I don't think we need the Belcher right now. I think I would probably just drop the Bender.
Okay.
And save the Belcher for when we need to taunt. When we have a low health medium, should he start pressuring us, which could happen. We've got Hex, so I think we're feeling pretty good. I just came back from a nap. Holy shit, this deck. Yes.
Deck is insane.
For those of you just tuning in, screenshot this baby. It's a really, really good deck. We actually have the option to have 5 from our 7
cards. Yes. Pick the fire, right? 5 of them.
Fire Rally is really good. You are really silent. Yeah, I mean, I'll boost myself up again, but... I don't know.
Aww.
I'm probably just gonna be too loud after this, but whatever. So, what did he do?
He played that. Yeah. Is that worth the hex?
It's most likely worth the hex. So what would he play next turn? Maybe a Bog or an Obsidian. I'm gonna have 4 from Kraken, so I'm gonna need 3 damage.
Oh, we have the Horse Rider.
Doesn't work. So if we're roping, you can hex it and play a Belcher, I don't mind, but let me just see if I can find something better for now.
Oh, we're not roping.
What happens if we just Yorimar here? Alright, we'll take the hex, play the Belcher.
Hex, Belcher.
It's pretty good. Just thinking that he must have an Obsidian in his deck, Obsidian Destroyer or Bog Reaper. I feel like he's testing the waters with this tournament. I didn't really like anything that wasn't the X, because this is a really good tempo swing anyways. Oh wow. Prepping the Kraken. Alright.
Damn.
So, shall we Kraken us into it?
Yes, we shall.
That's good. Yeah. That worked out, guys. Look at that.
Being insane.
Looks like we're gonna be bringing it home, guys.
Feels good, man. With Shaman, with Smoke Shaman, this is the best.
All the one Shaman. It's a pretty rare feat. I think my last 2 Shamans were playing. My last 2 Shamans have been sick there. The previous one wasn't as good as this one. It came close. Did my previous one have like 2 Lightning Storms, guys? I can't remember. It was pretty good as well.
This card has 6 mana. Warlord. Oh, Warlord. I mean, do we just play Arts? We Flame Tongue.
I'm thinking there's a really good evolve in here. If the Kraken free kills the 6 and the Belcher free kills the Shredder. Because we're getting a 10 mana card that we're usually not too shabby.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just not sure. I mean, we definitely don't want to evolve any 1 mana cards because those could be Doomsayers.
Yeah.
I think I like Belcher into the Shredder and then maybe we get the Horse Rider, whatever comes out. So, let's start with that. Yeah, Horse Rider.
So we Horse Rider.
Yeah, and then the 9 goes into the 6.
And we evolve?
Yep, evolve here looks good.
Oh my god, hi main. 10-10.
Yeah, and then I like Hero Power, Coin Frost. Actually, we have to play around Brawl. Probably fine just passing. Just play on MC Tech, play on Brawl.
Okay, just yep.
Like, how does he beat this, right? Without a Brawl or an MC Tech?
I don't think he does.
Yeah, it starts with like 1-3 into 10, then an Execute, but even then, right? Even then, you've got a high main and a 3-5. Alright. GG, just concede. Alright, this is pretty sick. Alright, GG!
We did it!
That's some self-restraint there, right? To not add anything, but I think that's really the only way to lose. Like, he has a brawl that he has.
Yeah. So we got 12 wins with this shot. Oh my god, this is amazing. Right,
before you open your packs, could you first screen share again?
Screen share? Yeah, sure.
Chat. That's like the best part for the chat. Just seeing the packs getting opened.
Okay. Wait, screen share. Share screens, okay, can you see this?
Yeah, 1 second, I'll put it on the main screen. There we go, look at those 5 packs ready to get opened, guys. Yeah, awesome. All right, very good. That's okay, right? That's
yeah.
375, that's 405, a golden card in a pack, yeah.
Let's open the pack too.
Oh yeah, it's a good part. Back to 8 win average? I think so, guys. We did a lot of good work today. We got a 12, a 12, and a 7, so that puts us back over 8, I think.
Okay, it's not the worst.
Yeah, I think, you know, after that Shaman deck, I think we've used quite a good...